Hello guys, and welcome to another MK Mobile boss battle video. Guys, today we are doing battles 100 and 120 in Fatal Earthrealm Tower. I guess probably all of you know that I have every single Earthrealm Tower piece maxed out, including the epic ones. So the tower itself won't be really that much of a problem for me. However, at certain points I decide not to use my gear so I can make it a little bit more challenging. And my previous video I basically showcased how you can use the Princess Guard epic piece so that you can bypass the hex modifier. And a lot of you said that they prefer just tagging in and out, which is perfectly fine for me. Actually, I received also some comments from people who have this piece at Fusion Zero saying that it's not really working good at Fusion Zero because it expires and you don't have enough time to do another special too. So with all that said, I reckon that probably you need to have this piece at least at, let's say, Fusion 2 or Fusion 3 in order for it to be effective. Sadly, I have no way to check because I have it maxed out. And when it is maxed out, you have absolutely no problems because the incurability effect lasts for 15 seconds. With that said, basically, I'll be showing you my gameplay of Battle 100. And because I asked you, do you want me to play with maxed out epic equipment so I can just wreak havoc and destroy every single boss without any problems? Some of you said yes, some of you said no, so I decided to do two battles of Battle 120. One of them with my MK11 team with really strong and even maxed out epic pieces, of course. And the second one, I'll be using classic team without using any Earthrealm Tower epic pieces. So I'll be using just two pieces and they are both blue pieces. One for attack and one for defense. The other two pieces are the Princess Guard, and sadly I used Scarlet piece, even though I could have used Lucane piece for a blockable chance, but for some reason I decided not to. I have no idea why. I literally forgot actually that the regular blue piece for Lucane gives some blockable chance on basic hits. I literally forgot that. Anyways, the important part is that I hope from the gameplay about 120 using my classic team you get an idea how to destroy these battles using just classic Lucane and the Princess Guard. I couldn't have done this without the Princess Guard. That was really, really important. As you will see, I didn't use any equipment whatsoever on my other two characters, which I paired with classic Lucane, classic smoke, that's really, really important, and Nunjitsu Scorpion. And I didn't use any tower equipment, actually didn't use any equipment of them, because I wanted to use just classic Lucane. That's the point of the Princess Guard. That's the point why I'm using this equipment. And actually, in a lot of cases, if you are lucky with the little hits, you can do pretty insane damage with it. So I wouldn't say that it's useless once maxed out, of course. Now, one more thing. Battle 120, guys. You cannot really tag in and out. I'm sorry. All of you who said that they prefer tagging in and out, please let me know how you beat Battle 120 by tagging in and out. Now, please do not send me videos with maxed out epic tower pieces. Just like regular equipment, how do you defeat this battle by tagging in and out? Because it's not really that easy, trust me. If you tag in and out all the time, the moment you face Sub-Zero, you are going to get frozen and you're going to get killed. I almost died with my classic Lucane. So it's really, really risky to tag in and out when you're facing Sub-Zero in this team. He has the Weather Warfare maxed out. So this is the time when the Princess Guard comes in handy. And this is the main reason why I use that. The first battle, 120, I used MK11 team, but just before I beat it, I closed the game. Yeah, I lost one attempt, oh, big deal. And then I did it again using classic team with classic Lucane. And yeah, basically you're going to find the timestamps for every single battle in the description of this video. So I will just let you now sit, relax and enjoy. See you next time, guys. And one more thing, guys, currently you're watching at my first game with MK11 team with crazy strong equipment, and after that we'll follow the game with the classic team. Just want to let you know something important. Blue stacks sometimes lag so hard that you can literally lose the game because of it. If you're wondering how I lost my noob cybot in the first battle, I locked hard. Hopefully, actually, luckily for me, I didn't lock in the next battle. So now I will let you sit, relax, and enjoy the classic fight.
Simply too fast.
Excellent.
Perfect.